Yo, get your Quitwing City shirt today, and also get your hashtag Blastoise Bros shirts today, and get your Squirtle Shitter shirts today at TeePublic.
What's good, guys? This is JD Zero bringing you another PokeTuber versus PokeTuber battle against the one and only Freeze or Burn and Burnex, basically. And basically, we're having a battle because I already told you the guys in the update that I was gonna get a battle against another YouTuber, and he wanted the challenge because he saw my videos. So. And I eventually watched his videos. Basically, he's not a bad battler. He's a pretty good battler. And I want to see what he got today. So, we're going to have this battle. And it's going to be pretty awesome. Before I get even more into this, when we did the battle, basically, because I'm actually pre-recording this battle because my voice didn't get onto the actual, to the actual video because my mic was off. So that kind of sucks. So we're going to do it right now and it should be pretty epic. So we're already sending him the request. Battle. Sending the request to battle. Battle. Oh my gosh. And letting you guys know, my voice is still kind of like eh. Oh, I mean, I didn't let you guys know before, but my voice is kind of like dying out or something like that, kind of losing it. And it's kind of sucks. I was kind of sick, but I kind of like feel way much better. It's just the voice in my throat. It's just terrible. Just super, super terrible. So, like I said, guys, we're gonna go ahead and against him right now. And I was fixing the little camera here, getting it all equaled out, try to, balance it to the way it needed to be. If it looks off, it looks off because of it. And then I try to fix it later on. So his first set of Pokemon was the Charizard X, the Galvantula, his mascot, Gliscor, and a Drapion, then the Apollyon, and Makuhina. I mean, kid you not, this team was a threat, though. I was like, there's no way in my first match that I might able to live out of this. And it felt like I might live out of this. I don't know what was going on. I was like, there's no way. There is no way I will win this match. But. Somehow, I prevailed. I kid you not, I freaking prevailed. At the second match. I mean, the first match. This first match that's about to start right now. You'll see exactly what I'm talking about in this first match. But the second match, giving you already a little sneak peek of what's gonna, I kinda got a little bit of a reveal. So I'm picking my Pokemon, he's picking his. And we're gonna go ahead, jump right into it. Let's see. So, what was it? I choose my tripod. He goes for the Galvantula because I predicted that he was going to choose his Galvantula. And that's what he did, was choose his Galvantula. And I know he was going to try to go for the Sticky Webs, so I went for the Stealth Rocks. Because I was like, okay, there's no way this Galvantula is going to really take a hit from EQ. But if I can land a Toxic off, then it shouldn't be able to still be able to, you know, take this EQ. So I did send out Toxic. I do land the Toxic. But somehow, at this moment in time, he was super bulky to the fact that he can't be EQ'd by Earthquake. And I don't know why. I just don't know why. Here we go. Watch. How about the EQ. And what does it do? Half of that. Very half of that. And I was like, come on, it's EQ. Electric Pokemon is weak to ground. What the heck, you know? I mean, I understand Steel types being weak to ground, but come on. EQ. That should have taken out this Pokemon, but it didn't. So now I feel like maybe I should have just used my fighting move instead. That should have probably taken him out. But other than that, I got it poisoned. So all I need is one more turn and it's pretty much gone. So I sent out my Leonardo just because I was like, okay, I need to get these Sticky Webs off the field. My team is not going to be any use as their Sticky Webs up. So I go for the Rapid Spin. I don't Mega Evolve. I just go for the Rapid Spin. And he stayed in and let me Rapid Spin the Sticky Webs away and basically kills his Galvantula. Well, he stays in and try to use Energy Ball to take out my Leonardo, but that didn't happen, so that was pretty good that he was trying to go for something like that to take it out, and it didn't work. At this moment in time, he sends out his little Hikamita or whatever. Sometimes I get the name right off the bat and then sometimes I forget how to pronounce it. I'm sorry guys. But he sends it out and I decided to go for an Aura Spear, trying to see how much Aura Spear would do. And it didn't do that much. And he goes for the knockoff, trying to knock off my item, but I'm a Mega Blastoise, so items can't be knocked off. But it did a good amount of damage coming from a knockoff, so he had that point where he's like, okay, I can get 2 hits for a KO off a knockoff. So that, it was interesting how he just said, you know, knockoff. And I sent out my Professor X, trying to hopefully get a Psychic off. But what I was not expecting him was to switch out. And what he switched out was the Drapion. And when he sends out Drapion, because I forgot that Drapion was actually a poison and dark type. I completely forgot. So don't you know, get on me about it, but I completely forgot that Drapion was a freaking dark type / poison. That is like the best typing you could go against when you're trying to have a Psychic type Pokemon. Go against it. But I couldn't land the Focus Blast. If I would have landed the Focus Blast, that Focus Blast at least would have taken it out. But I didn't land it, so that kind of sucks. So far, his Drapion is pretty much winging it right now. And I decided to go into Gengar, the Joker, and see if I could hit up a Willow. If I could hit up a Willow, I could, you know, decrease that attack damage that he has. Now, the one thing I wasn't expecting that Drapion would also have knockoff as well. So he knockoffs my focus band. That did a lot to the point where I'm basically down for a two-hit KO from his Drapion. I try to go for a hax, and I believe I get the hax off. But it doesn't kill it. It did half damage. And I'm like, well, isn't hax supposed to do double the damage when the Pokemon is basically in status move? That should have did a lot more damage than that. You try to say this thing is like really bulky in defense? Oh my gosh, that is not cool for this thing to be that bulky in defense or special defense. It should be getting dropped, but it didn't. So I sent out my Tyranitar, my Godzilla, and I decided to get the stand up. I was thinking, what should I go for? Because this Drapion is really dangerous at this moment in time. I could switch out again, or I could go for the Stone Edge and take it out. And I did for the Stone Edge and took it out, but it didn't take it out. It got a Whirlwind up, so I wouldn't be able to take it out. Now, he dies off the sand. So the Drapion dies off the sand. Only have two Mons up. Understand, I only have two Mons up. I only have the Godzilla and I have the Claw here. And he sends out his Charizard X. Goes Mega on his Charizard X. I go Mega on my Caesar. And it just like, wow, you know, what can I do? I can't really do anything. I should have went for Bullet Punch, but that probably wasn't going to happen. I mean, it could happen, but it wasn't going to get that much damage. The reason why I wouldn't be able to get that much damage is because he was going to go for Fire Blitz. Fire Blitz would have automatically KO the Claw. And I wasn't able to switch out either because I was trying to go for the U-turn and I'm not outspeeding this Charizard X. Charizard X outspeeds, my Claw, so I won't be able to go for the U-turn. I should have go for the Bullet Punch, probably somehow getting somewhat of a damage off, but that wasn't the case. So I kind of learned from that mistake where I should have just, whatever, Bullet Punch, it should work. It should get at least enough damage to the point where it should KO this Pokemon by sand at least or something. I don't know. So now we got to the point where, okay, I have Godzilla. All I could do is either one Stone Edge, two EQ. But his other Pokemon that I want to EQ won't be EQ. So all I could do is Stone Edge. And I only have 4 PPs of Stone Edge. So one, I use the Stone Edge. Two, I try to land a couple more Stone Edge, but that didn't work out enough for me and my favorite to win this first match. So he sends out his Empoleon. His Empoleon basically wins the game, no matter what you guys say. His Empoleon wins the game. If I would have had to choose Earth, EQ, and that was the point. If my, Godzilla wasn't Choice Scarf, I could have EQ. But I missed the Stone Edge, and he goes for the Skull, and that ends the game. That basically ends the game. Well, he didn't end the game. He still got the Skull off, but he didn't end the game. I go for a Stone Edge. That didn't really much do anything. Like I said, I wish I would have had the Stone Edge. I mean, I wish I would have Earthquake or something like that. But he decided to go for the Flash Cannon that basically ended the game right there. So that's the end of the first game. I got him down to his 3 Mons, but he pretty much took my whole team out in that first game. Now We're gonna go into the second part of the game where things went a lot different. Not that as I was expecting it to go, but it went a lot different to the point where it was in my favor of the game. So here we go. Here we freaking go. Oh my gosh, my nose. Did you that? My nose is bothering me. Let's see. I wish I could just, you know, speed it up just a little quick, like pause the recording and then speed it up. But we're just gonna go ahead, like I said, go into the second match here. And I was basically messaging him, and then we were gonna just start the match. But right here, watch. Here we go. So basically, I was letting him know, yeah, it was a good match from that part. I told him, yeah, he could switch the team from his battle box instead of his party. So I'm guessing this is his party, this his party team. So I tell him, yeah, you could switch it to your battle box team. I don't mind. And so basically, since we only have the first two matches that were with the same mons, we had the same party with the same mods, but the last match that we had, he actually went to his body box, his battle box team, and used his battle box. So now this match here is like, I wanted to do a different setup, but I decided, no, let me just start off with tripod again and see if I could get a better setup moveset with my team. And kid you not, it was a great setup right here. So this time I sent out tripod. This time he doesn't send out his Galvantula. This time he actually sends out his Charizard X. Now at this moment in time, I'm like, what could he possibly think? What he's about to do right now? I can see him going to Mega and try to get something off. Probably maybe EQ. I can see him probably EQing my tripod here. I get the Stealth Rocks. And he does go for the EQ. So I was like, okay, nicely predicted EQ. But I feel like I should have went for reversal or go for the EQ. I went for the reversal. I should have went for EQ. Because since it's now a point where, one, it's a fire type, two, it's a dragon type, and now it's on the ground, so I should EQ. My extension, my thoughts would have been like, oh, EQ. There's no problem for me to just EQ. I can EQ and take it out. Instead of doing reversal and taking it out. And that's not what happened. So I sent out my Leonardo and I was like, you know what? Let's just have a starter versus starter right here, right now. I'm not gonna Mega Evolve. Or did I Mega Evolve? Did I Mega Evolve? Did I or did I not? Let's see what happened. What is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and there we go, Mega Evolution. So I do Mega Evolve this Blastoise, and I was like, God. He goes for the EQ. Look at this EQ. It did like about mid 30. Percent of HP. I wasn't really worried about it. It was like a mid 30 HP took it off. I was like, okay, you got mid 30% off of my HP. Cool. Whatever. I'm dandy. Yes, I'm dandy. I'm very dandy. Now he sends out his Galvantula. I'm thinking like he might thunder or try to set up the sticky webs or something. But this time he just like, I want a Volt Switch. Volt Switch does a lot. kid you not, it did a lot. I am surprised at how much it did. I was like, I was not expecting that a lot. But he sized it to a lot. And my Blastoise survived it. For some odd reason, it survived it. I go for the Aura Spear, try to take out his Empoleon, his Popper, his Mr. Poppers, and it does not take it out. I wish I had Aqua Jet or something on here, but I'm like, nah. I go for another Aura Spear. It does outspeed this Popper. So at least I know this turtle is actually faster than this penguin. And I'm surprisingly, I thought it wasn't going to be faster, but it's faster. So he sends out his Galvantula again. I'm basically expecting that he's going to do another Volt Switch out. I see why he's not going to do it. It's pretty obvious he's going to do it. So I decided, you know what? I'm going to stay in. Did I stay in? I think I switched. I was like, I'm going to save this for later. So I switched, predicting that he might do something electrically or grass-wise. But this is not the case. He used grass. He literally said, I'm just going to energy ball and wing it. And he did. He didn't do too much damage to Godzilla, but he winged it with the energy ball. So that was good on his part, getting some damage off with the energy ball. I thought energy ball was going to do a lot more, but it didn't. So that's good. That's good. Then he does go for the sticky webs, and that kind of sealed my fate right there, because like I said, Blastoise, my Mega Blastoise, is pretty much weakened to the point where technically he won't be able to rapid spin that situation out. He really won't. Then he sends out his mascot, the Gliscor, and decides to I think I did Stone Edge. Oh no, I used Pursuit because I was thinking he might switch out if I wasn't gonna, you know, really do anything. But he decides to Swordsense, and I was like, oh my, Lanta, not Swordsense. Why Swordsense? So I decided to switch out. At this moment in time, I was like, no, this is not about to happen. I switch out. I switch it to Professor X, because now, at this moment in time, he has two sword stances up. He's pretty much at plus four. I get stuck in the sticky web. It does not make me outspeed. I still outspeed his Gliscor. So what I do is go for the Hidden Power Ice, because that Hidden Power Ice should take it out at this range. Oh, sorry. I got a itchy ear. Okay. Anyway. So I do take it out with the Hidden Power Ice. The problem was when he sent out his Hakamita. So he sends his Hakamita, his handy, and I was gonna go for the Psychic. Wow, he predicted the Psychic and sent out his, you know, this little creature here. And I was like, oh, okay, that kind of sucks. So I wanted to go for a Focus Blast, try to see if I could get anything off of his Focus Blast. And I landed, but not as I expected to be. I was expecting a little bit more. But he just goes and knocks off my Professor X, getting the Life Orb off as well, when that didn't really matter. But he pretty much just KO'd my Professor X. So I decided, you know what, let me just go ahead and send back the Professor, I mean not the Professor, but the Godzilla instead, because now I could probably just go ahead and either EQ or Pursuit. Sorry, I just hit the mic. Oh. Did I EQ or did I Stone Edge? I think I Stone Edge. Oh, I think I EQ. I definitely think I EQ. Or did I Stone Edge? Huh. Well, let's just see what happens. I EQ. Nice. Nice play, high part. I EQ. Got the EQ off. But now he's down to his last Mon. And that was the Hikamita, the Hakamita, or Hakura, his handy. Basically, he's down to his last Pokemon, and it's his handy. And I go for another EQ. I only have four Mons. And I know he's going to eventually take out Godzilla. So that's why I'm going to go ahead and set, you know, I might as well go ahead EQ. See how much damage I get off his EQ. And it doesn't do that much. So now I'm down to three Mons. Because he took out Godzilla. And I decided to send out my Mega Blastoise. Because I should be able to outspeed it by a little bit. But I don't think I'm actually able to outspeed this Hakamita. Because I'm pretty sure that I'm pretty much slower. By this speed that I just got dropped. Pretty much lower, so I won't be able to take it out. I try to go for an Aura Spear, try to see if I will be able to take it out, but it basically just close combat and took me out. So now I'm down to two Mons, down to Gengar, and what was the other Pokemon that I had? I think I still have my Claw, basically. So at this moment in time, I have the Claw and I have Gengar. And I decided with Gengar, I just wanted to either Willow and then hacked it off, or just hacked it off. So I went to hacking it off because I feel like the Willow's, I don't need the Willow, I could just hack it off and that would be game right there. So I pretty much won this part with the Joker with two, and I was like, cool. So now we're 1-1. Damn it, I just hit the mic again. So, like I said, now we're down to 1-1, and here's the third match. This time, he actually switches his Pokemon to his box Pokemon. And his box Pokemon look even scarier than his actual party Pokemon. And I was like, oh my gosh, so much threat right here. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, so much of a threat right now. He has so much of threat. He has this Slowbro, and I'm thinking like this is probably a Mega Slowbro or something. And then he has the Ferrothorn, the Volcarona, the Nidoqueen, his own version of Godzilla, the Triceratops, and then he has the Chandelier. So he either has the Mega between the Slowbro or the, you know, Tyranitar. And what I figured out, it was actually the Tyranitar that was his Mega Evolution. So I was like, okay, at least it's not the Slowbro, because if it was the Slowbro, I would have had even more of an issue because it was the Slowbro. But that was not the case. So now I was like, what should I choose? What should I make of myself? And how should I present it out? Should I start off with Tripod again, or should I change the setup? Now, let's see, what did I do? And I'm like, this is recording right now today and everything, and I just already forgot what to say and how to put it down there, because I thought I had the mic recording and the mic wasn't recording it, and I was like, this is ridiculous. So let's just see what we do. Okay, I choose Alakazam. So I choose my Professor X, and he chooses the Tyranitar, his own version of Godzilla. And what happened here was I wasn't expecting a crunch from his Tyranitar. I was not expecting it. I was trying to get a Focus Blast off, and it didn't work. I should have just went for the Hidden Power Ice, because I think Hidden Power Ice would have probably did some damage. I did go for the Hidden Power Ice. Never mind. I went for the Hidden Power Ice to see if I could get damage off, but it didn't do that much. I should have went for the Focus Blast. That's what it was. I should have went for the Focus Blast to get damage off instead of going for the Ice, the Hidden Power Ice. And I just didn't know if I was going to either miss or not miss. Miss or not miss. So I set out my claw and I was like, okay, let me get Sword Sets up. I know it's not going to do anything. Let me get Sword Sets up. Let me Mega Evolve and get Sword Sets up. So that's what happened. I Mega Evolve, got the potential Sword Sets up. He goes for his own Crunch again. And it does about a good so-so amount of damage. About almost halfway through. About 40% of HP down. So about 40%. Get about good 40%. I got the Sword Sets up. That was all that matters. I got basically got 2 Sword Sets up. So now I'm plus 4. I was like, you know what? I'll be greedy. I'll go for another Sword Dance to get plus 6. So I'll be at max plus 6 Sword Dance. And that's what I did. Because he eventually said, you know what? Let me switch out since basically I got you paralyzed and you can't outspeed me. But that wasn't the case. So I had Bullet Punch to outspeed. Now, he sends out his Ferrothorn, and that was the major threat right here, because his Ferrothorn has Iron Bars. His Ferrothorn has the Rocky Helmets. This is when I figured out he had Rocky Helmets, because when I went for the the Bullet Punch, and I got Iron Bar, it didn't do that as much. But once I realized I got a little bit more damage off, it was like, oh, so you're basically one of those carry the Rocky helmet. So I was like, I don't know what to do. I don't want to switch out. I just go ahead and went for another Bullet Punch, and he's trying to leaf seed me. He missed the first one, but he's trying to leaf seed me, and I'm like, I'm not trying to take this leaf seed. So I don't mind if I sack off the claw, because I do not want this thing to be leaf seeded by this Ferrothorn. So here we go, where I already picked my move. I already decided what I wanted to do. I go for the Bullet Punch. It did enough damage where it could have taken it out. If it was a crit, it would have taken it out, but it did it. And I got, Iron Bar and Leech and everything. But I die off to his Leech Seed. You get a little bit of HP back, but not as much where I could still not probably take it out, because I could have took it out. So I decided to, send in my Tripod, because my Tripod would basically take it out. And that's what happened. And I think I went for EQ this to take it out. Yeah, I was like, I'm not going to touch you with Reversal. I'm just going to EQ with Earthquake. And that's what I did. And I guess he didn't switch out. I think he should have switched out if he was going to preserve it. But he decided not to switch out. Now, at this moment, what was it? He sends out his Slowbro. I set up Stealth Rock, so he sends out his Slowbro. This is where I'm gonna actually set up Stealth Rock. But just on his Slowbro, I was predicting that he's gonna basically scald me. That's pretty much what he's gonna do. That's all he could pretty much do, is probably scald, and that's what he did. So he does get the scald off. He does land the scald. This strike me down to 1 HP. I can't really do anything to this Slowbro, because all I have is EQ or the reversal, And then I try to get some toxic damage health because I think it's one of those refrigerator sets type Slowbro. And I was like, if I could have got that toxic off, that would have did damage. I would have probably get him into that range where I needed to be at. If that didn't happen. So I said, you know, let me send in Joker. Let me see if I could get a Willow and get it burnt. And let's just see what happens. So, he switches in his Trichinotaur, his Mega Trichinotaur, and try to set up the sand and everything. But I was like, can I land this Willow though? And it avoids the attack, and I didn't land the Willow. And I was like, this sucks. I want to land this Willow. I try to go for the Willow again because one, he could take me out with his this is where I messed up the scream though, but I got the Willow off. But yeah, I kind of messed up the scream there. My freaking camera dropped and everything. He does get the bite off. It does get to the point where it almost dropped me down, but the sand did its job and drops me down. But as long as I had the burn, that was good enough for me at the point. But here we go, when I try to fix the camera, I sit out my Blastoise because I feel like, you know what, Blastoise, you should do good work here. You should be able to take out this Trichinotaur. And knowing the fact that that was the case where my mascot was going to go get his Trichinotaur and it was going to go down, he decided to switch it into the Slowbro, his Bob. And I was like, okay, can I get a Skull Burn? And I was like, nope, not happening. No Skull Burn. I was like, oh, that kind of sucks. I was hoping for a Skull Burn. And then I was like, should I go for another Skull and Burn? Because that's the only way I could do it, right? So I decided to go for another Skull and try to see if I get a burn. I go for the Skull, still no burn. He goes for the Calm Mind, and I was like, oh snap, not this kind mindset. Oh no, not happening here. So this time, I was like, lucky I outspeeded. Now I could go for Dark Paws, and Dark Paws should take it out. But it's not going to take it out at this range because he just used Calm Mind. Calm Mind kind of pretty much put him up where I won't be able to take him out. So go for the Dark Paws. It pretty much puts him in a range where it could be 2KO'd, and I did get the flinch. So that was perfect because if it didn't get the flinch, he was going to set up another Calm Mind and that would took me out. So I was glad that I got that flinch. All I needed to do was Dark Paws again, and it's gone. It's out of my face. I didn't have to deal with it. Gosh, my nose. Jeez. Took it out. I was like, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Blastoise. Thank you, Leonardo the Blastoise. Oh my gosh. Thank you, mascot. Thank you. Took it out. He sends out his Volcarona. And this is the problem where I was like, oh snap. Oh my gosh. Volcarona. Lucky it has Stealth Rocks, but that did a lot of damage and he got most of it. So I was like, okay, all I could do is Skull. He goes for the Bug Buzz. It increasingly down it, but it's like, okay, well, I survive. All I need to do is Skull, and it's taking out this Volcarona, and it took out this Volcarona. So I was like, nice. This Blastoise took out two mons by himself. That's good enough for me. Then he sends out his Chandelier, and I was like, dang, I keep hitting the mic. But he sends out his Chandelier. He has Energy Ball. I was like, there's no way my Blastoise is gonna survive that Energy Ball. I was like, you know what? Okay, whatever. I sacked off my Blastoise. I was like, cool. So this time I was like, you know what? Let me just send out my Godzilla. Why not? And I was like, can I EQ? Because I should be able to EQ. It's not levitating. It's a fire type. It's ghost. But it's not levitating. I should be able to EQ and take this thing out by EQ. So that's what I did. I EQ'd. Took out the chandelier. I was like, sweet. That chandelier is gone. I don't have to worry about the chandelier. Now, the point is, he sends out his Needle Queen. And I was like, okay. At this moment in time, I'm thinking we're going to trade EQs. So I go for the EQ. And I do a good amount of EQ. Not to the point, but it's enough to the point where it could be, you know, basically a two-hit KO for this EQ. He goes EQ for his own. It doesn't do that much. It does about get 75% of it. Or at least half of 75% of it, like a good 70, good 72% of it. But it was like, okay, you know, whatever. I took out his little Needle Queen, and he sends out his mega freaking, you know, Tritanitar. And I was like, well, one, I got you burned, so your EQ is probably not gonna do as much. I'm going to go for EQ. We're going to trade for EQ. I get an EQ off. It does necessary enough to the point where it could have been taken out if it was a crit, but not as much. He goes for his EQ. It doesn't do as much either. He does get the burn. That burn basically almost KOing it, but it didn't. And I was like, okay, let me just go for another EQ, and that EQ does KO his freaking Mega freaking Tritanitar. And I was like, thank you. So that is 2 win victories for me. And I pretty much died off with one. So I won with one Pokemon, and that was the MVP Pokemon, I Godzilla. So I was like, awesome. And literally, I'm about to say GG to this guy because it was a very awesome match. Like I said, you can check this guy in the description below. His link to his channel will be in the description below. He's not a beginning YouTuber. He's pretty much got more subscribers than I do. But yeah, comment, share, subscribe to say he's on. Stay awesome, guys. Bye.